Hi all, I welcome you all to the next lecture today. Today we are going to start the third unit of Introduction to Aerospace Engineering. Myself, Professor Ravi Kumar, School of Mechanical Engineering, Sastad MTV University, Tanjore. Today's topic is, today I am going to give you flavor about the general types of construction, particularly wing and fuselage structure. How do they look like? What are the different various subcomponents of these structures? In prior lectures, right, in the introduction to the aircraft, we have seen the purpose and objectives of wings and fuselage, right? Particularly, we had talk about what is the contribution of wing in the aerodynamic efficiency, overall aerodynamic efficiency. So wings are the structures, right, which are basically designed to get a lift, right, particularly lift that will support your aircraft weight while it is flying, right? And fuselage is your central body, right, to which particularly wings are attached. And fuselage will give a spacing for particularly cockpit where your pilot used to be seated, and all control panels required to, you know, fly your aircraft will be, you know, situated or installed in the cockpit region. It will also give space for the passengers, particularly, right, seating arrangements. It will also house the cargo compartment, right, where you can store the luggage, particularly when we talk about the passenger aircraft. If you talk about the fighter aircrafts, right, then particularly it will have only two compartments. One is cockpit where pilot will be seated, and along the compartment where your aircraft engine will be housed, right? And all payload will be attached to the aircraft wings, right? So today we will see the detailed view of construction of these components, particularly wing, and what are the different components of wing that will be going through, right, as well as fuselage, how does it look like and what are there inside. Those all information will be shared with you. So let me start our discussion, right, with the forces. As in the semester, particularly you are going through the subject called strength of materials, right, where you might have been given, right, exposure to the various forces, stresses, right, and corresponding, you know, analysis also you might have done. So first we will go through what are the different forces which will be acting on the aircraft, right, particularly wing and fuselage. Then we'll go one by one on the detailed discussion on these, particularly wing and fuselage. So if we look at particularly when an aircraft used to fly in the air, right, it will be subjected to the differential pressures that we term as air load. So when aircraft is in air, it will be subjected to longitudinal forces, lateral forces, as well as tide forces, right? So if we consider aircraft, fuselage as a beam, right, it will be subjected to the tension, right, particularly at the tail and at the nose, right, it will be subject to tension. If we look at the central portion, it will also be subject to the compression, right, because of the differential pressure at top and bottom surface of the fuselage, it will also experience the compression. Due to the side forces and due to the engines which are attached on the aircraft wing, right, engine will have a propeller, right, and the propellers will be, you know, inducing some sort of torque on the respective wing. So because of that torque, right, it will also, fuselage will also experience the torsional effects. And there are some regions in the aircraft which will be subjected to the combined, you know, loading. There may be a combination of bending and torsion. There will be a combination of compression or torsion. There will be a combination of bending and torsion, bending and compression, right? If we look at the aircraft skin, particularly, aircraft skin is a thin membrane, right? That will be subjected to basically shear forces. Particularly, it will be subject to more and more shear forces along the surface. So we focus on the fuselage. Fuselage mostly in the aircraft, you know, fuselage, if you look at the, you know, cross section of fuselage, will be something like circular cross section. So if we look at, you know, the edges of, you know, fuselage, so at the top surface, you know, the fuselage will be subject to the tension because area is getting expanded, but at the bottom surface of the fuselage will be subject to the compression. So as a whole, right, similarly on the surface, it will be a shearing, shear forces will also be acting. So due to the combined effect of this, right, aircraft fuselage will be subject to the bending as well, right? So it is will be a combination of tension and compression and bending, right? So aircraft fuselage will be subjected to the combined load condition, right? Combined load condition. So this is the pictorial presentation where aircraft engines are basically inducing the torque on the aircraft fuselage. So in this case, you know, overall effect will be like your aircraft is subjected to the torsional stresses. Because you look at these two engines are situated on either side of the wing, right? So they are attached with the propeller. So propeller rotation basically is inducing a torsional, you know, stress over the wing, and wing are attached to the fuselage. So overall effect is like there is a torsional stress is getting, you know, transferred from wing to the fuselage. So complete aircraft is subjected to the torsional stress. Similarly, if we look at when aircraft is going to be land, right? So when aircraft is going to be land, we cannot, you know, make lift zero, right? It will be requiring some lift. So when lift is requiring, right, top surface, basically there will be negative pressure at bottom surface. There will be a positive pressure. If you look at the overall, you know, effect when aircraft is coming on ground, there will be ground effect as well. So the combined effect will be something like that. Aircraft will experience tension right at the bottom surface, particularly near the center gravity, right, and either side of this, you know, aircraft will experience tension effects, and top surface will be, you know, subjected to the compression when it is going to be land. And opposite to when it is going to be takeoff, in that case top surface will be under basically tension and bottom surface will be under the compression because of that differential pressure acting on either side of the aircraft wing. So during landing, you know, bottom surface under tension and top surface in the compression, and vice versa in the case of you know, takeoff. So these are basically if we summarize the total forces which are acting, you know, aircraft overall aircraft when we talk about, then on various component different kind of forces would be acting. So when we talk about overall, you know, structure of the aircraft, there will be bending stresses, there will be compression and tension stresses, there will be shear stresses, and at some areas where you will get the combined effect of these stresses, right? Bending torsion may combine to form a combined stress condition in particular components. So if we come to the fuselage particularly, right, so most of the airplane structures, if we look at total, you know, overall structures which are present, which is present on a particular aircraft, we can divide that into this segment like fuselage, then wings and empennage, right? Empennage is the tail portion, right? Basically, horizontal and vertical stabilizer combination itself is called empennage, landing gear and power plant, right? So like that, you can say there are total overall five, main components of the aircraft, right? Then there are sub-components, right? There are various sub-components, right, of the aircraft that we will look at one by one. So this is the detailed view, right, of an aircraft. When you are dividing it, you'll get this kind of, you know, main component like this back portion, right, of horizontal and vertical stabilizer. This will stabilize the aircraft particularly. It control two kind of motions, right? Yawing and pitch controls are available on empennage. So this is the empennage, right? This is the main wing, right? Right and left wing. This is the main wing, and this is a central body, right, to which wings are attached, and these all subcomponents are attached, right? This is called fuselage, right? So as I said, you look at the fuselage thing, right? It is providing the space for cockpit. This is the area, right, a cockpit where pilot used to be seated, and all control panels will be installed here. And followed by the space which has been provided here for passengers, right, which will be seated here. And bottom surface, if you look at, bottom surface will be for cargo particularly. So front nose, if you look at, this is the power plant, basically the piston cylinder, piston propeller aircraft, right? This is basically a general aviation aircraft. If it is a passenger aircraft, in that case engine will not be here, it will be under the wing, right? And this is landing gears, right? Basically, it is a tricycle landing gears, right? Two wheels are under the man wing and one is the nose. This is the landing gear to support the aircraft on ground and during takeoff and landing. So these are the five main components of an aircraft. And today discussion, basically, we are going to look for a wing and a fuselage, right? We'll look at the wing, what many subcomponents are there, and we'll also look at the fuselage. So we just focus on the fuselage construction. The fuselage basically includes the cabin and cockpit, which contains seats for occupants and controls of the airplane. In addition to it, the fuselage may also provide room for cargo and attachment points for other major airplane components. So your fuselage is very, very important part of your aircraft, to which all the other components will also be attached. So those components will share the forces, right, respective forces to the fuselage. So if we just look at the fuselage configuration, basically there are three kind of configurations, right? Truss type fuselage, monocoque fuselage, semi monocoque fuselage. So if we just look at the first type, right, in early days, right, particularly before 1960s, all the aircraft particularly would be using this kind of configuration, that is called Warin truss. So we look at the truss will be having the diagonal and vertical members. Those are known as wave, right? And there will be longitudinally running members, right? These members particularly heading from the front to the back, these members particularly we focus on, these are known as launcherons, right? This is the vertical wave, this is the diagonal wave. So if we just look at the construction, why this kind of construction was selected at that time, if any one of this member is going to be failed, right, let's suppose the vertical wave is going to fail, that doesn't mean the entire structure will fail. And another thing is the load distribution is uniform in this case. So any one member will not be subjected to very high stresses. So stress will be uniformly distributed along the various members. That's why we consider the Warin truss or truss kind of structure for the fuselage. Even you look at the TV towers or long towers for communications, we are using the truss kind of structure, because truss kind of structure is basically made on the fail-safe design philosophy, where that means if any one member is going to fail, right, rest of the member will be able to take up the load shed by that failed member. So the company structure will not fail all of a sudden, right, by the failure of single member. So basically some aircraft utilize an open truss structure. The truss type fuselage is construction, if you look at, they will be constructed based on steel or aluminum tubing. And strength and rigidity will be provided by welding the tubing together into series of triangular shapes called trusses. Alright, construction of Warin truss features longerons, right, those longitudinal running members, as well as diagonal and vertical wave. To reduce the weight, small airplanes generally utilize the aluminum alloy tubing, particularly because aluminum alloy are lightweight, right, light in weight, so which may be riveted or bolted into one piece with cross brushing members. So second configuration immediately after that came monocoque fuselage. So if you look at the construction of monocoque, it will have formers, right, and bulkhead. This is for this is bulkhead, this is the formers, and this will be supported by the skin. So this is bulkhead, former, then bulkhead and former, like that it will go. So this is a skin. So particularly most of the load will be carrying out by the skin. So skin must be having sufficient strength to counter all kind of forces, right? So the material which we are going to use for the skin should have very, very high mechanical property, particularly strength, winding strength and all. So this configuration is also known as stressed skin configuration. So what is the biggest disadvantage with this kind of configuration is, when we are going for very, very high strength material, carbon percentage will increase for that particular material. So weight penalty is the biggest issue with this kind of configuration. And the aircraft design Particularly, we talk about the lightweight material because we need high strength to weight ratio for the aircraft. So in that scenario, this kind of configuration was not fitted well. So there was a weight penalty, particularly for this kind of configuration. But this is having high strength compared to the variant dress. And in look at the variant dress, in variant dress, the space was less, right? When space particularly provided for the passenger and other cargo compartments is less in the case of, you know, variant dress. But in this case, you know, space is more, right? We can utilize it for passenger separately and cargo separately. So even though space requirement got increased, but there was a weight penalty in this kind of configuration. So the first aircraft which utilized this kind of stressed skin, you know, concept was the Shuriken, right? So that has utilized the stressed skin construction in 1935. So it was the all metal stress skin particularly. So this skin was sufficient, was having sufficient strength to counter all the forces, right, which will encountered while aircraft is flying. So particularly, you look at the inner construction was as it is, right, the triangular construction, but outer skin was having sufficient strength to counter all the problems. So these are the bulkhead and formers were also available. So spacing, you know, particularly if you look at the spacing for utilization is more compared to the truss kind of structure. So the load bearing skin provides a closed high stiffness pass for shear stress, contribute to bending stress and stiffness. So due to this highly bending stresses, right, our material particularly was a big challenge, right? So we were using the high strength steel or aluminum alloys. When you are going for very, very high strength, the carbon percentage will increase, and due to which weight penalty was the biggest issue during that time. All right. So if we just want to visualize how does it your monocoque structure look like, you take the example of this Coca-Cola cane. So it is having only this outer skin, right, which is basically supporting all the weight, right? Internal pressure and external pressure is bared by only this skin, right? So this kind of structure it was. So now you can imagine when aircraft is flying, right, it will be subjected to varying pressures, right? Inside pressure will be higher than the outside pressure, due to which, you know, your fuselage will be subjected to the compression as well as tension. And if your skin is not sufficient strong enough to, you know, taking care of these stresses, your structure will fail, right? So that was the big limitation for this kind of configuration. So we have to use only high strength material. There is no other option. So the monocoque design uses stress skin to support almost all imposed load. This structure can be very strong but cannot tolerate dents or deformation of the surface. All right. So as no bracing members are present, the skin must be strong enough to keep the fuselage rigid. A significant problem involved in monocoque construction is maintaining enough strength while keeping the weight within the allowable limits. Due to this limitations of monocoque design, a semi monocoque structure is used on many of the modern aircrafts today. So if we look at the semi monocoque construction, just you look at the things here inside, right? Earlier version, there was only bulkhead and formers, right? And there was no longitudinally running members. But here, longitudinal running members are also there to support the load, right? So compared to the stress skin, right, load sharing will be uniform in this case, and it can sustain higher stresses compared to the monocoque construction. Another problem, we can use ordinary material for the skin, because now we are having sufficient strength provided by the bulkhead and former in collaboration with the longeron. So now even low strength material can be used. So if we compare the performance characteristics of monocoque and semi monocoque fuselage, right, the thrust to weight ratio in the case of semi monocoque configuration, aircraft will be higher compared to the monocoque construction. Alright, so that's why most of the modern high agility aircrafts are using only semi-monocoque construction. So this is the longeron bulkhead, and this bulkhead will be connected to the outer skin by stringers. So stringers will attach the skin to the former, then formers will be attached with the longeron. So there will be uniform load distribution from wing to skin to former to longerons. So this is the wing attachment points, particularly here wings will be attached, and up to this, you know, look at up to the cockpit, this longerons, longitudinal running member are going up to the tail. These are the longerons, right, and followed by the bulkhead formers, right. This is the firewall where engines will be attached. So if we look at the detailed view, if we remove the skin, that fuselage will be looking like that. So circular ring kind of structures will be present. This is the first one is called bulkhead, right? This is the bulkhead, and followed by the formers. These are all formers. These are the stringers, right, which will attach directly to the skin, right? These are the longerons which are running, right? Vertical member, this vertical running member, this, and as well as this, right? These are known as longerons, and these are the stringers, right, which will attach to the aircraft wing. Aircraft skin, this is the outer skin. So this is the detailed view of semi-monocoque configuration of fuselage. So semi-monocoque system uses a substructure to which airplane's skin is attached. The substructure, which consists of bulkheads and or formers for various sizes and stringers, reinforces with this stress skin by taking some of the panning stress from the fuselage. Alright, so on a single engine airplane, right, the engine is usually attached at the front of the fuselage. There is a fireproof partitions between the rear of the engine and the cockpit or cabin to protect the pilot and passengers from accidental engine fires. That is called firewall, as in the image it is given here, right. So this will protect particularly engine fires to come inside the cockpit. Alright. So this partition is called firewall and is usually made of heat resistance material such as stainless steel. To overcome the strength to weight ratio problem of monocoque construction, a modification called semi-monocoque construction was developed. It is also consist of a frame assembly, so bulkhead and former as used in a monocoque design. But additionally, the skin is reinforced by longitudinal member. These running members are called longerons. So longerons usually extend across the several frames members and help to skin support primarily banding loads. They are typically made of aluminum alloy, either of a single piece or it is a built-up construction. Right, built-up construction. So if you look at the stringers, right, stringers are also used in semi-monocoque fuselage. These longitudinal members are typically more numerous and lighter in weight than longerons. They come in variety of shapes and are usually made from single piece aluminum alloy extrusions or formed members. So stringers have some rigidity but are used for giving shape, particularly for the attachment of skin. So stringers and longerons together prevent tension and compression from bending and bending the fuselage. So in the diagram itself, it is looking, you look at, these are basically stringers, right, which are attached. These are providing the shape to the outer skin, right, and these are longerons which are running starting from cockpit up, going up to the end, and these are all stringers which are attached here. This is stringer, right, and this is bulkhead and formers. If we look at the fuselage materials, right, particularly the semi-monocoque fuselage is constructed primarily of aluminum or magnesium alloys. Although steel and titanium are sometimes found in areas of high temperature, particularly where we are attaching the engine, there we can use the titanium alloy, right, particularly. So individually, no one of the aforementioned components is strong enough to carry the loads imposed during flight and landing. But when combined, right, all these, you know, subcomponents give the sufficient strength to overcome the flight loads. Alright. If we look at the attachment particularly, that is called fuselage connection with gusset. The gusset is a kind of joint basically. This is one of the example of gusset. So gusset will have rivets and bolts, right. So this is a component with the gusset, rivets, nuts and bolts. screws and even friction stir welding. So gusset is a type of connection, right, bracket that adds strength. So this kind of, you know, things basically will provide this strength to the fuselage. So those longerons and, you know, formers will be, you know, connected together with the with this kind of, you know, joint that is called gussets. So advantage of semi monocoque over monocoque construction, if we look at the bulkhead frames, stringers and longerons facilitate the design and construction of streamlined fuselage that is both rigid and strong. Right, spreading loads among these structures and the skin means no single piece is failure critical. That means in the case of monocoque, if your skin is going to fail, your complete fuselage will be damaged. But in the case of semi monocoque, even your skin is having some damage, still your longerons and you know, stringers and bulkhead will be a strong enough to carry out the load imposed by the air, right, in the aircraft. So by rigid strength wise, you know, semi monocoque is better than the monocoque you know, construction. And as well as if you look at the spacing requirement, right, spaces provided for the fuse means the passengers compartment will be higher and larger than the monocoque construction. So this means that semi-monocoque fuselage, because of its stress skin construction, may withstand considerably damage and still be strong enough to hold together. So it will not fail you know, all of a sudden, but monocoque construction will fail if your skin is going to be failed. If we look at the fuselage basically designed, right, fuselage are generally constructed into two or more sections, right? So on a small aircraft, they are generally made in two or three sections, while larger aircraft particularly, they may be made up of various you know, sections. Their sections may be six or more, right, before being assembled. So fuselage will not be, you know, considered as a single go, right? So it can be divided into small you know, sections, and finally they will be assembled together, right? They will be assembled together by using rivet and bolts, right? Finally they will assemble. So in a smaller aircraft we will have only two sections. In larger aircraft may have various sections, and finally they will get assembled. So if we just review the things, right, what we have covered today. So first kind of, you know, configuration was the truss kind of configuration, right? A fuselage design made up of supporting structures member that resist deformation by applying loads. It's called truss. If you look at the construction of truss will have triangular sections. Those triangular sections will be made up of vertical and diagonal running waves, right? And those will be supported by the longitudinal running member that is called longerons. What was the disadvantage of truss kind of configuration was that space provided for passengers and cargo was less compared to other kind of configuration, right? Then monocoque came into the picture. So a monocoque is a shell kind of fuselage, the design in which the stressed outer skin is used to support the majority of imposed stresses. Monocoque fuselage design may include bulkheads but not stringers. So stringers were not there, right? Longerons will also not be there. So your skin material that you were using there should have high strength to counter all the loads coming in the you know, air when aircraft is going to fly. So biggest disadvantage was that there was a weight penalty. So thrust by weight ratio was less, right, compared to even truss kind of you know, fuselage construction. But space provided for passenger and cargo is bigger than the truss kind of, you know, fuselage construction. Then finally design that semi monocoque construction came into the picture, right? So the disadvantage of, you know, monocoque was you know, resolved by adding the longerons and stringers to the monocoque design. So now even a low strength material can be used for the fuselage skin, but it will have higher strength because load distribution is uniform in the case of semi monocoque compared to the monocoque type of, you know, fuselage. So a fuselage design that includes the substructures, bulkhead, formers along with the stringers, longerons to support flight loads and stress imposed on the fuselage. So this is more effective design compared to the previous two kind of, you know, fuselage design. So that's why most of the high performance aircraft or modern aircraft, civil or military aircrafts are using this semi-monocoque kind of structure. So loads and fuselage, particularly if we look at when we talk about the loads, the fuselage should carry the payload and is the main body to which all parts are connected. It must be able to resist particularly bending movement caused by the weight and lift of from the tail, torsional load caused by the fin and rudder, and cabin pressurization. The structural strength and stiffness of fuselage must be high enough to withstand these loads. At the same time, the structural weight must also be kept within the given limit. So there is a particular limit of weight of aircraft. We cannot cross that. If you are going to cross that, overall efficiency of aircraft will suffer. Fatigue is a phenomena. Basically, aircraft fuselage will be subject to the cyclic loading, right? Varying loads at various section, right? So that kind of load is called as fatigue load. So fatigue is a phenomena caused by repetitive loads on a structure. It depends on magnitude and frequency of these loads in combination with applied materials and structural shape. So fatigue critical areas are at the fuselage upper part and at the joints, particularly by which your other components are attached to the fuselage and fuselage frames particularly. These areas particularly should be given more attention, right, when we are designing the fuselage. So today discussion, right, I'm closing the discussion here, right? So today we have covered the general construction of fuselage. In the next class, when we will meet up together, right, I will give you the detailed view about the wing construction, how many kind of configurations are there in the wing. So as a summary, right, we can summarize the things here. We have covered today the loads acting on the aircraft. So then we have seen a detailed things about various kind of fuselage configurations, right, starting from truss. In the olden days, particularly, we were using the truss kind of configuration. Even today also, right, for general aviation aircraft, we are using the truss kind of, fuselage configuration. Then monocoque came, then semi-monocoque came. With this, I am closing the today's discussion, right. If you are having any doubt, right, feel free to contact me, right, via WhatsApp, or write in the comment section. So I would be happy to resolve your queries. So see you all with a new topic in the next class. Have a nice day. Good day.